begin the performance, please take a moment to notice the location of the emergency exits, the passageways to either side of the stage, and the double doors through which you entered behind you are clear exits from the room in the event of an emergency. In order to keep the performance enjoyable for everyone, we ask that all cellular phones and pagers be turned off at this time. Also, please remember that food and drink are not permitted inside the auditorium, and that the use of flash photography and audio or video recording is strictly prohibited. Thank you for your attention. Please enjoy the performance.
enemies will never rest until we are all destroyed.
How can they create more suffering? What evil minds can think of more ways to torture us?
The only certainty is that more women will join us here in this limbo hell wrought from greed and hate. Centuries ago, I leveled my curse against Helen for stealing my son Paris's heart and bringing about the destruction of Great Troy. I proclaimed her guilty. She was responsible for the deaths of all of those who fought for her return. I called her a witch, whore, and begged her husband Menelaus to kill her for my children's sake. My curses against Helen have been returned to me 1,000-fold. The gods have decreed that I must live out the horrors of all the world's wars and suffer the endless miseries of each war woman. I witnessed this again and again. Countless ages have I relived my own torments each day as if they were new. Countless ages have countless wretched women passed through this place. Countless more will come.
Dad, the puzzle is that easy.
Will no one help us?
When a walkie one copy went to the late top of comedy,
will more women meet our fates?
Soon we will hear the orders given. Come from yourselves. The soldiers are preparing to return.
Hope is too far distant for these ancient eyes to see. Cry out for your souls, ill-fated angels. Your sun is set.
Trembling, we come to ask you whether the soldiers have finally resolved to take our wretched lives, whether they again will rape us, mutilate us, bury us alive.
Rape and torture of women is one of the hellish certainties of war. The tales of our misuse are as great in number as the sands on our beaches. Still, we must wail these cruelties till the suffering ends.
Ecclesiastes!
Listen.
Call the soldiers of Venetian New Manasse de Tumon Père.
When the soldiers came into our home, they threatened to kill my father.
Mais les façons ont mis mon tête à quai. Ils ont dit, t'as une prostituée!
But the gunmen turned on me. They said to me, you are a prostitute.
Ils ont cupulé à Boulogne, ancien mes mains, ancien mes jambes, lots autres prestigeurs!
They pinned me down, one of my hands and one of my legs. The others took turns.
J'étais tenue pour des quatre heures de temps pour si elles ont fait ses violées!
I was held for 4 hours and raped repeatedly.
Comment vous m'avez parlé, c'est tout vieux! Tu m'as pensé, j'aime pas!
When my family eventually found me, they had to carry me home.
Sad soul, if you alone suffered such a crime, the darkness of it could diminish 1,000 suns. We together feel each injustice and fear the soldiers will devise even worse torments.
Strakorimoshi Pontiati is Kurkamani
to us.
Kodavoya Namaichi!
Where will we go?
Biti Namadabu Deopian, Inache Date Ache,
and after all, they're giving us whores. What monsters will take away our very souls?
Now messengers from the many armies come, with stores of fresh hell to bestow on us. What will they say or do that can bring us to greater pain?
Dios te salve Maria, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo.
Bendito sea. You pray in vain for protection from these warrior devils. You must not cower and let them see your fear.
Si! Estoy asustada. Hace 2 años cuando estábamos dejando a Neva, nos hicieron salir
de la 2 years ago, as we were leaving Neva,
the soldiers
made us get out of the bus. They killed the young man I was with, and I was raped by 8 or 9 soldiers.
Cuando llegué a Neva,
when I arrived in Devieva, the paramilitaries were there.
Dijeron que eras guerrera.
They said, you are a gorilla!
El comandante me viola.
The commander of the paramilitaries raped me and said that if I talked, people would say I was asking for it.
Fui a Medellín.
I fled to Medellín.
Ahora estoy atrapada aquí.
Now I am trapped here.
Cuando los ejércitos vienen,
when I hear the armies come, I start thinking that it's going to happen to me all over again.
Como un pesadilla que nunca termina.
Like a nightmare that never ends.
Be still, soul, Talthybius!
give up. Fallen queen.
Wait. Something has changed. I do not know you.
Wretched woman. You know us. We are the messengers of your enemies.
This should be Talthybius, messenger of the Greeks.
We have come many times to tell you of your faith. We come with the word you heard many times before.
I see the many faces that have spoken for Talthybius, each from another world. No matter the messenger, the hateful news is always the same.
Our leader has decided your fate already, if that was your meaning.
With my Antibia, Otten,
we know you very well.
Yes, my Antibia.
I know you. It was early morning when your troops attacked our village. I ran outside to see what was happening in the streets. Saw my brother get shot and fall to the ground. I ran back into our house and saw my mother get shot. During the chaos, I was hitting bullets. I was losing blood and strength. I had just enough time to put my baby on a straw platter and leave the village. Everything. Everything is burned out before our eyes. Your soldiers ruined our lives.
You speak nonsense.
My ancient memories begin to slip away. This is the moment I have come to dread most of all. I see the miseries of my past through ancient eyes. My vision blurs and the details are gone. Though I know the news to come will freeze my blood, still I am compelled to hear each hateful word. Ghosts of my past, though I have heard the news 10,000 times, I'm cursed to learn it new each day. Therefore, tell me of my daughter Cassandra.
The great Agamemnon has chosen her for himself.
The merchant priestess of Apollo served up as meat to the beast of war.
Any woman should consider herself lucky to be made the whore of such a great king.
Lucky? Daughter, I pray that you crawl into a far corner of your troubled mind and escape this hell they have planned for you. And what of my other daughter that you stole from me?
Sweet young Polyxena?
Yes! Where is she? Why isn't she here with me?
She is near, and watches over Achilles' tomb.
She watches a grave? My daughter? Then she is alive! Bring her to me!
Your daughter is content where she is. She is free.
Say what you mean, free. Tell me, is she still alive?
Your daughter is dead! Death makes her free!
Death makes her free?! Is that the only freedom our children can hope for? Who did this?
Neoptolemus drained her blood over the tomb of his father.
The murderer who butchered my husband has slaughtered my baby. How many hearts do I have to break? My youngest girl sacrificed like an animal.
Your son Paris killed Achilles. Her blood pays his debt.
Achilles killed my son Hector!
Because Hector broke Achilles' heart by killing young Patroclus.
Achilles' son Neoptolemus murdered my husband Priam. This is an endless chain of blood revenge. What about Cassandra? No. What about Andromache, widow of my iron-hearted son Hector?
Neoptolemus has taken her as a concubine.
Concubine? Slave to be used for sex. As for me, I am forever doomed to endure this hell. What comes next? How much must my soul endure before I find peace?
Yours is a story that has no end, until the appetites of war are satisfied.
God help me. I am forever trapped in this abyss of men's hate. We, sisters of war, undone and forever lost.
Poor queen, we are all damned to this purgatory. So did me leave in Ajiporia. Each of us relives our tortures. Every day I must again be stripped and marched with raised hands to the ditches we dug with our own hands. I see the graves already filled with naked bodies. Nazi Sonia Shekunibaba. Tibon Nexi Mugelic. The Nazi soldier cocks his revolver. Perhaps it is stuck, for he fiddles with it. Yepachi Diego Iwanmobi Niatakrenko. I look up at him and he says, not so fast. In spite of that, we lay down so as not to have to see the bodies. My little girl asks me to cover her eyes. She is afraid. I hug her head and cover her eyes as she asked me to. With my right hand, I hold her tight. I felt heat in my left arm. She'll make a beach in Astro. A bullet passes through it, penetrating my 10-year-old daughter's skull. She never even shivers. Outwardly, apparently, I do not show signs of life. After a while, the SS brings another woman and child. The woman's last wish is to kiss her child. The murderer did not allow it. She kneels beside me on my right hand side and leans her head on mine. The slaughterer shoots and her blood spurts and oozes down my head and collects at the back of my neck and in my hair. From the back, I surely look as if I'm dead. You did this! You destroyer!
She thinks she has recognized us! Was it me? Was it him? Or him?
Just as I thought.
Just another insane woman spreading their lies! What is that like? Crazy women, are they burning the prison cells? Or just setting themselves on fire?
That's so funny!
You call us insane?
It's not funny!
I'm not insane!
It's not funny, but I'm not insane!
If I was insane, I would not recognize your face!
You are neck and more golden!
You are a guard at my house! I was in a block with my daughter Rachel and many other pregnant women and little children. My Rachel got pneumonia. I tried to hide her sickness as long as I could. Finally, you took her away to a hospital unit. She never returned.
When babies were born, the outback and old need me to gazan.
When babies were born, they were also taken and never seen again.
I must have nicked my baby again.
I did not have to give you my baby.
My kleine young mother told geboren.
My little boy was born dead.
Mehrruf, an old born ausgebildet. Die kommen der anderen Frauen, Kinder und Babys zu beseitigen.
Several of us were chosen to dispose of the bodies of the other women, children, and little babies. We were to drag the bodies from a pile to a ditch where we were to burn them. In the bottom of the pile, I found my Rachel. The other women let me take her to the ditch.
You, my mother, are ever troubled with your tears, lamentations in the mourning for my father's death and for our country, I am making this torch to blaze and show its light in your honor. This torch for marriage. This torch for death. Come, lead the dance with cries of joy. Pray that I greet my father's happy fate.
husbands tonight. They all loved me. Each one harder than the next. Follow my steps. Now here. Now there. Come. Kiss the bride on her wedding day. Sing! 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 Hymns and songs of joy. Go. Sing to my marriage.
Her story is not as it was. Cassandra was to serve as a concubine to King Agamemnon. The rape of Cassandra and her lost mind is used to your legend.
Child, your mind mistakes your rape and enslaves it and calls it marriage.
No! No! No!
We will not dance, sweet soul. Poor women, for her wedding song, give her your tears instead.
Come to
ass.
Mother mine, you should not pity your country or my marriage, for I will destroy them. And the house of Atreus will fall.
How sweetly you smile as you tell this dark prophecy. The creators of war should quake with fear to hear these omens.
I see in my mind my mother was killed centuries ago and wanders in limbo now. What this can mean, I do not know. These women are lost. I see the many crimes of war upon them. This is too much to see. Centuries of merciless conflict, destruction, rape, death, mutilation.
If the people lead, the leaders will follow.
This is not her fault! Weep for your family. Let go of your hatred. You were never queen, my mother. You did not lose your country because we women have no country. We Trojan women are punished for our heritage, for what's in our blood. We must be cleansed. We are also punished for our sex. During and after war, there is no safe haven, no place to settle. The way from this place is not the river Styx, but on a sea of unity. Dry your tears, sweet mother, for I see a day where we are revered, not scorned, cherished, not despised, protected, not violated. I see a day.
You see a day. More visions. These are nothing more than the idiotic ramblings of an insane woman.
These men will not heed Cassandra's warnings. Her curses will fall on their heads.
But the provision for our future seems to be made of fantasies.
Hecuba, I am sorry for your daughter. Pray to the gods for comfort.
No! Why call on things so weak for aid? Reliable gods are few and far between! Cassandra spoke of yesterday, today, and tomorrow as a seamless whole. She seemed to know that time has collapsed here in this forsaken place and spoke of new visions.
What does this mean? After centuries,
Andromache, where do they send you?
To the Greeks. Nothing is left in this dead place.
They tell me you are given to Neoptolemus.
It is true. If Hector was alive!
We cannot call him back.
Hector!
My son. My son, my brave son. Priam, come. Take me to my rest in Hades' halls. I cannot endure this longer.
Your son? Your misery is not special. You are not the only one to lose a son. My son was butchered. 6 men in balaclavas kicked down our door and burst into our home. Without a word, they seized Ahmet, my 22-year-old eldest son, and dragged him outside. They tied him to a telegraph pole. Then they blew him up and vanished. I had to go and pick up the scattered bits of his brains. My 4 daughters and 2 other sons less than 10 years old witnessed the killing of Ahmet. Yet we have all kept silent, overwhelmed. What can we say? What can we do? In Chechnya, nothing shocks anyone anymore. They never explain a thing. And I can't prove it ever happened. I'll never know why my little boy was killed when he wasn't a soldier.
One day in my village, the soldiers came and killed all the men and the boys. I was left with my baby and my 3 little girls. At the riverside, I was raped by a group of 6 in Rahamwe, one after another. I knew all of them. They said they were raping me to see if Tutsi women were like Hutu women. After they finished raping me, they threw me into the river to die along with my children. My children all drowned, but the river spit me back. I floated back to the riverside.
Streams of tears in all our houses. The dead alone forget their grief and never shed a tear.
What relief it should be for sufferers to weep. After the ages, our tears have become acid, our laments turn to bile, and our combined grief is turned to absurdity.
Our new home across the sea. Barely a trinket to remind us of who we were. No time has passed. We are slaves. The wife and son of Hector. Slaves.
Cassandra has also been taken into slavery.
Poor Cassandra. There is even worse news, and it breaks my heart to tell. Our Polyxena is dead. I saw her broken body with my own eyes. I covered her with my shawl, but was dragged away without a chance to say a prayer over her.
Polybius told me Neoptolemus murdered her at Achilles' grave.
I am sent to the hands of a monster. Polyxena is lucky.
What?
It would be better to die than live in this hell before such Macora.
La mole vina so falla,
Madame Chauve! Life and death are not the same.
La tosse d'une mole vina, let me go, let me place pour l'espérance.
Life leaves place for hope.
Tonga, sanga, hivong.
Life leaves place for hope.
Tuimi, duimi, ba, ha, make da, da, ding.
I was captured by the Americans and taken to Danang. They put electricity in my vagina, on my nipples, in my ears, in my nose, on my fingers. Blood ran out my vagina. At night, they put electricity inside my body and they beat me. They stomped on me with their shoes. Now when I try to breathe, my whole chest hurts, and when I lie in the bed, my body aches. Death is better than life with misery.
Is this what I have to look forward to? My destiny is to be a murderer's whore. And who can tell what abuses I will face? The dead feel no sorrow and know no grief. I thought that I would grow old with the man I loved. My handsome soldier Hector. He was filled with wisdom, a lion's heart, and a loving father to our son. And now he is murdered, and I a slave to the filthy lust of a murderer. Therefore, is it wrong to say the dead Polyxena has less evil to endure than I? I have no hope. The last resource of every human heart. Hector promised to take care of us. Women of war, our husbands are dead. Our heroes are dead. Every day for 2 weeks he passed by my mother's dress shop. He brought me candies and flowers. One day he asked me to meet him near the soldiers' camp. I met him, and we walked to a stream just next to the tents. When we were alone, he said, "You are a very pretty girl and smell so sweet." Then he grabbed me and tried to pull me onto him. I told him to let me go. Then he held me down, pulled up my skirt, and pushed his hand into my panties. When he found out that I was a boy down there, he hit me in the face again and again. He called his friends over. They hit and kicked me. 13 of them raped me for 3 days. Again and again, I begged them to stop and asked them why they were doing this. One of them said, "If you want to dress up like a woman, you deserve it. That's what a woman gets." One of them stuck a knife into me and said he would make a vagina if that's what I wanted. I escaped with broken ribs and a bashed in face. Outside my town, I saw policemen. When I told them what had happened, the policemen handcuffed me and took me to an alleyway.
You fucking whore! You fucking faggot!
Mi puto la patria, quita mi father, come costum sagre, de mi vol, arrancando mi pelo.
Then he threw me down on the back of the patrol car, ripped off my skirt and my bloody underwear, and raped me, holding me down and grabbing my hair.
El segundo mi vol, ega.
The second officer also raped me.
Me tiraron por el piso de ano. No se puede volar un hombre!
They threw me on the ground and said, a man can't be raped!
Son tus maridos. Tu padres, tu hijos, son tus héroes!
These are your husbands, your fathers and sons! These are your heroes!
To do such vile things from their mothers? God forbid! I do not have answer to these questions that have followed us since the bells of time first rang. My sons did wrong in their time. Paris's obsession with Helen brought about the fall of our country. Hector, he was true and noble. Yet, Andromache, no tears of yours can save him. You will raise my grandson to know the kind of man his father was. Quiet! The soldiers come to tell us of some new plan.
Andromache, I would rather cut out my tongue than give the orders that my king delivers to you. But we must do so, for he commands it.
What is it? What can you say that will make our lives worse?
It is ordered that your son is... How can I tell this news?
Just say it!
Will he be given as a slave to a different family? Please don't separate us.
None of this world's chiefs shall ever rule over him.
I don't understand.
I have a son his age.
What? I cannot breathe! My son! What about my son?
We ought to kill your son.
No, that is a lie. That is a lie. You cannot take my son.
Our commander says he will not raise an enemy son to one day seek revenge for his country.
He is no threat. He is a child. My little boy.
He must be thrown from Troy's walls.
No.
Let us take him calmly and he will show more wisdom. Do not cling to him, but show him your strength.
God, help us! Someone help save my baby!
No one will help you. No one comes to save him or you. Think. Your husband is dead. Your city defeated.
Ik vind nog dat ik onder een van de latrine stond.
I remember I stood at the edge of a latrine.
En ik nog dat het mijn kindje en hoe het steen er boven.
And I remember dropping my baby down the hole and throwing stones on top of her.
Ze leefde nog.
She was alive.
Ik hoorde haar schreeuwen toen ze hoorn viel.
When I threw her, I could hear she was still screaming.
Ik deed haar met te redden.
I did this to save her.
De soldaten hadden brought the ladies in there.
The soldiers were to skin all of the babies.
Can anything be more insane than that a man has the right to kill us, our husbands, our children, because he lives on the other side of a river, and his ruler has a quarrel with mine, or that another man stole his wife, though we have not quarreled with him. These are not our wars.
My mother tried to save all of her children. She had been out gathering food. We hiding under some garbage.
That is my beloved.
As she neared the house, she was stopped by some soldiers. I heard everything. The soldiers asked her, "Where are your children?" My mother said, "I do not know." They threatened to bury her alive. My mother said, "I do not know, I do not know." But they decided to kill her. They shot her in her head. The soldiers found my younger sister, my older sister, and my little brother. My younger sister managed to run away, but the other two could not. The soldiers took off all of their clothes and buried them alive. Protect your little boy if you can.
Do not do anything that would bring you shame. Do as we say, and we will not torture him.
Stardex, listen to me. You must go with these soldiers. Why are you crying, my baby boy? Do you know your fate? Why do you clutch me with your hands and cling to me? Your father cannot rise from the grave to protect you. To hold this tiny body next to mine, mother's greatest joy. Kiss your mother now for the last time. Put your arms about me and press your lips to mine. I love you, little one.
What good is a mother's love if it cannot save her children?
Why?
Why kill my son who never wronged any? Take my baby and bear him away. Hurl him down if you must, then feast upon his blood. Seems that it is heaven's high will that we must perish. And I cannot keep the reaper from my child.
Unhappy women, your many millions you have lost to the wars of man. Children lost as victims of war. Equal value to all the dirt
your life. What can I do, my luckless sweet boy? My heart is so full that I choke on its overflowing. It is done!
Choice but to obey my orders. I could have lied to my commander and told him that the deed was done. My life's purpose is to defend my own country and to obey my orders. I live to serve. Our mission must be upheld.
I became a soldier to serve my country. I never even knew what our mission really was. It was an Iraqi girl, 15 years old. A soldier in my platoon charged the others $50 each to rape her. He left. Then he only made $500 before she hung herself. She was also a child. Was this our mission?
Business, war. Nonetheless, the deed is done. Andromache begged me of Ptolemy's permission to bury this poor dead child. When he denied her, she pleaded that we bring the boy to you so that you may have some ceremony. So bury him, but do this with speed. I have already cleansed his wounds. A pity. Reminds me of my own son. Now we will go to dig a grave.
Place my grandson on the ground!
A father and a king.
my memory. I know that Menelaus should appear to mock Paris and take Helen from this place. This is not the Menelaus of old. I see the game continues. The past will speak through this new devil. Menelaus!
I came to Troy to punish the man who stole my wife. Traitor to my hospitality. But he has paid the penalty. He is dead. And his country too. They came to take that woman from here. I will not call her wife, because that will do her honor. For now, she's but one among the other whores who share these prisons as captives. Now, my purpose is not to put her to death here. I will carry her home, and then tear her to pieces, and fertilize with her flesh the ground of our homeland. Men, drag her out by her hair to me. Grant her this because of your words, and not for her own sake.
I know you blame me for these wars. Why would you bleed for me?
Your beauty has forever been your curse. If men kill because they love us, then they are not lovers, they are murderers.
If men kill for love, they are heroes. We protect what is ours. Say what you will. You waste your time. Nothing will change your fate.
Listen!
Since I was a child, I've had to protect myself from men who say they were victims to my beauty. No one cared that I was wise or kind, but they sniffed around like dogs waiting for me to crawl under them. I learned that my body was somehow theirs to claim, not mine to give. I learned that I must become the thing that men have created me to be in their weak minds. Sex became my defense. I used it for safety, for food, for power. I am sorry for my sins. But not the sins that men have passed on to me! You call us witch because you fear us! You call us whore because you cannot truly own us! If it is your will indeed to master goddesses, that very much shows your folly! See us for what we are, Menelaus! See us!
Hecuba. Again the story strays. This is not the Helen we have seen so many times.
Sister, these are strong words, and I too am compelled to speak.
No! She has caused the death of all you love and the fall of your city.
Listen! Is it impossible to think that a man's beauty could imprison us? No! We are called the witch, the whore, the seductress. I argued long ago that advancement drew you from Menelaus to Troy. Often I advised you, saying, get you gone and let my sons alone. I'll help you slip away. End these wars. But that was wrong. She is not to blame for the deaths of the men you led to slaughter in her name.
Menelaus! She was your wife, not your property. The fear of shame in other men's eyes drove you to this madness. Oh, gods, lay your curse on men who wage war and choose to destroy and not to create. Bring your curse on Menelaus and all men who love war.
I do not love war! I loved a wife and she dishonored me. Paris disgraced me, and for this, Troy has suffered. And for this, Helen will die.
Her escape from your false marriage should have been a blessing to you both. Instead, your manly pride and fear of disgrace drove you to bring down a nation.
That woman, you talk of nonsense. I will have what is my right.
No.
There are those that wait to see you stoned. Your debt will be paid. Before this night is over, your dead face will dishonor me no more.
She has paid her lot. She owes no debt.
Ridiculous. Look at her. I was envied by kings. Then she was stolen from me. They laughed and mocked Menelaus, the fool who cannot keep a wife. This is your debt. So there's no burden for me to take your life.
time, great queen. Women have been prisoners to an image of unattainable beauty created by men. This image was and is a lie.
This makes no sense. The wars were fought for your return. Paris deserved to die. You were mine.
If love was not our bond, then why pursue me so? What madness makes you war for something you despise?
Helen, you have forever been a symbol of the perfection of our sex. In honor of your beauty, poems have been written, songs sung. Helen of Troy, beauty unattainable, the face that launched a thousand ships. You have taken on all the plight of our sex. Now, with matted hair, scarred body, and rags for a gown, you are more radiant than any goddess in heaven.
Is it strange that our legends tell us it was a woman, Pandora, who, because of her weak-mindedness, opened a forbidden box and released all the miseries onto mankind? Greed, vanity, slander, envy, and pining escaped, leaving only hope inside. Myth would have us believe that it was woman who brought these miseries into the world and stifled hope. If this story is true, war-loving men have barbed these miseries since and buried the box that hope was left in. Likewise, poor Helen has become sign and symbol for all women who bring woe to mankind. I do not know which of us did right or wrong in our time. I do know that we women must no longer be made to bear the burdens of the wars of men.
You speak of the present as if it is long since past. You would defend this whore? She will die the shameful death she deserves.
No!
Perhaps her presence
no,
in chastity.
No! No! No!
All
no,
her
no! 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 No!
Our fate strikes your lustful hearts with terror!
No!
Acuse! Casta Matisse Ponte!
Acuse! Casta Matisse Ponte! Time here is finished. Listen, we will leave this place. The gods have stopped watching us. Perhaps they are dead or have been for a long time. We are free from our imprisonment of spirit. Names, war women. Call on the ghosts of those that were sacrificed in the holy name of war.
Rahul and Dovid. My husband Benjamin.
great and small, forever may they whisper in the ears of every living soul.